I take back anything I have said about Jurassic Survival being pay to win. I mentioned in my last video about the wall how that questline was a little bit pay to win. And I was about to make another video really getting onto them because that questline got even more pay to win. But then this update comes out and they just made the questline disappear. The hunters were just like, just kidding, suckas. We just wanted to see how much we could make you spend. I know that if you're pay to win and you spend a bunch of money on that quest line, you are probably really pissed off right now. And you should be, because the money you spent on that quest line was completely wasted. So they're not pay to win because pay to winners and free to players are in the exact same spot right now. A new wall questline has appeared, and it's pretty fun, but I would not get your hopes up too high that it will actually unlock the wall, and if you learned anything from the last questline, do not spend money. I will give you my reasons why I think this questline is actually fake at the end of this video. The questline seems to have four main components. The first component is fixing the elevator motor. Since you can only do one mission every 24 hours, this will take you at least 8 days to complete. The fastest and therefore cheapest way to do it is to select insane six times, hard once, and normal once. This will cost you a total of 125 bolts, 72 gears, and 150 scrap metal. Every time you select insane, it will spawn around 50 enemies, with around 5 of those being bosses. Selecting hard will spawn 40 enemies, with 3 of those being bosses, and normal will spawn around 30 enemies, with 2 of those being bosses. The hunters have unlimited health, but they will stop fighting if they run out of weapon durability, so giving them guns will not only waste your guns, but it will require you to equip them with 2 weapons. For your first time, I recommend giving the hunters kukris because they are not that expensive to craft, and as I've mentioned in many of my Last Day on Earth videos, the kukri type weapon does the most amount of lifetime damage of any weapon in the game. Even on insane, each hunter will probably only use half of a kukri. Now, if you're a more skilled player, research team member and now semi-famous YouTuber Nico Desu came up with the cheapest way to beat insane mode. By running around to avoid getting hit, he was able to complete it using only 3 wrenches, 2 sets of tier 1 gear, and 63 pineapples. The only thing that I would add to his tactic is that I would recommend running around these tents in a figure 8 fashion. This not only lets you get away from your enemies faster, but it keeps them going slow so the hunters can get more hits on them. The second main component is to fix the fuse box, which will take at least 10 more days. The fastest and cheapest way to do this is to select insane 10 times. This will cost you a total of 180 blue tape, 150 transistors, and 200 wires. The third main component is to fix the breach in the wall, which doesn't make that much sense to me because we are trying to get through the wall, but oh well. The fastest and cheapest way to do this is to select insane 4 times, which adds 4 more days. This will cost you a total of 80 planks, 60 iron, and 68 stone bricks. There are many reasons I think this questline is fake, like it takes 22 days to complete, and it requires a crazy amount of resources, but those just serve as evidences that are usually found in these situations. I believe that those are used to mask the missing component, to make it harder for us to notice that something is not yet in the game. The fourth main component is also the main reason I know that unlocking the wall is fake. Fuel does not yet exist in the game. Whether they learned this from Last Day on Earth or they secretly are Last Day on Earth, this is becoming a trend for these games. Now, I'm sure that the wall will eventually be able to be unlocked, but we don't know if that will be in 17 days when people start finishing, or if this will be in 3 months. And now with Jurassic Survival, because of their last questline, we don't know if they're just going to scrap this quest completely and start over. I don't think they would do that, because if they did that consistently, I don't think anyone would keep playing the game. Even as it is, some great players are starting to get really frustrated with the game. Resbog just messaged me the other day saying that he was getting frustrated with Jurassic Survival because of all of their quest bait, which I thought was a pretty clever way of putting it. So I recommend doing it because it's fun and because you get to trade a bunch of common items for rare items, but don't get your hopes up that it will actually unlock the wall. I will be live streaming some of my progress on unlocking the wall every once in a while over the next 17 days so you can be updated on how it's going. Alright guys, I'll see you next time.